If you spend enough time there, you feel like part of nature rather than a spectator to it. That is an incredible yet humbling feeling. When the hunt is over and you finally have a chance to reflect, sometimes that reflection can be overwhelming.
Ducks, but no pilot. Good morning. It's Wednesday, August 26th. So we spent the night here at Grayling Lake. It's been raining all night. The pilot's over in Bettles, which is about 30 miles away, but he's socked in with rain and fog. So we're just hanging out at Grayling Lake and waiting for the weather to clear so that we can get out in the bush.
While waiting for the plane, we watched this young black bear browsing on the hillside.
Our pilot just got in a little bit ago. Finally made it in. You can see the weather is still pretty nasty, but we're hoping that tomorrow it'll clear up enough that we can get out of here and go hunt some Dall sheep.
The next morning we're cleared to go, so we helped get the plane ready and loaded up our gear.
Getting ready for takeoff. Headed out in the mountains. What is this, a little mall?
Yeah. Very spacious, as you can tell. Got me in the cargo bay.
Finally here after two nights in the U-Haul van, August 27th. Got a break in the weather. Still a low cloud ceiling, but should be sufficient to get us out there.
There goes our pilot. What do you think, Jens?
So we took about nearly an hour ride in the plane, traveling at about 120 miles an hour airspeed. So we must be about 100 miles from where we took off at Grayling Lake, maybe further. So we're out here.
We got dropped off about an hour ago, maybe a half hour ago. and we're just shaking out some of our gear. And as soon as the snow lifted, we were able to see a number of sheep up on the mountainside here. Pretty excited to be seeing sheep already. But it is cold. It's very cold. So we've set up a little tarp here just to keep our stuff dry until we get camp set up. And one of the trees that we set up our camp on seems to be a favorite for grizzly bear to rub himself on. Bear hair all over it. So, we're living with the bears and below the sheep.
Watching these sheep for a while, we decided to climb up the mountain to get a closer look.
So we've just climbed up this mountain over 1,000 feet to get up to the two rams that we've been seeing. So this is the draw. It's more of a mudslide and rockslide that we came up. And our camp is right down on the tip of this little peninsula here. We're hoping they still are where we saw them last, which is a couple hundred yards over that way.
Determined that these two rams were between 7 and 8 years old, but because we could not identify a full curl on either one, we had to leave them alone. So we headed back down the mountain to camp and stopped to say hi to this porcupine on the way.
Morning. It is day two in the field. Yesterday, I'm going to turn the camera here a little bit. Yesterday, we spotted two rams up there. So we went up to get a closer look at them. We climbed all the way up that, climbed up this rock slide up here, and then up across, got above the rams, and we spent a fair amount of time, about 60 to 70 yards away from the rams. Let those walk and came back down, and they're gone this morning. And it seems most of the sheep we've seen today are moving up to higher elevation. So we've packed up our camp, and we're gonna leave a tent here and pack light. But we've packed up our gear and our bags that we need for a couple of days, and we're gonna set out and go look for some more rams. So we're just climbing up this ridge, trying to get some elevation. So the sheep had been pushed down by a snowstorm, and this morning they moved back up. So we're moving up. Of course, now as we're moving up, it's starting to snow. So maybe we'll be going back down after the sheep, we'll see. For about, what, 3 or 4 hours, probably.
been sitting here watching these two rams. They're about 250 yards away. They're just not quite legal, we don't think. It could very well be 8-year-old rams, but they're not quite getting the full curl that we need. So, we're gonna back off and go to bed. Maybe tomorrow we can find a better ram.
We're literally going to bed with the sheep here.
So we're in a little saddle here right between two peaks, and we got our tent set up, and by the time we got our tent set up and caught in here, our water bottles are already frozen and we got frost on the inside of the tent, so it's pretty chilly up here. But we saw two sheep right before dark, and so it's all worth it. We're having a blast up here. We got little makeshift tent here. It doesn't have a floor. We got this is actually a trekking pole for a center pole, and this wonderful ambiance is Jens's dirty sock.
Just was making breakfast and this little guy popped out.
Chilly. We got a little more snow again last night.
Yes. Moisture management.
And a lot of work.
A lot of work.
When we wake up in the morning, the inside of the tent is dripping wet with condensation. Hiked over into a new drainage here to look for sheep. We found one. He's sitting down there, a little knob. It's not a ram, just a little guy. All by his lonesome little self. So we're a little disappointed over here, nothing here. We're probably gonna turn around and start heading back. Quite a hike to get over here, across some pretty steep and rocky stuff, kind of like what we're on right now. Thank you.
stalked those two rams, and we got to within bow range of them. And they aren't full curl, but we're 85% certain that they're 8 rams. We made the decision not to shoot them because we can't be 100% sure that they're 8-year-old rams, and we don't want to ruin this hunt by taking an illegal ram.
We had a lot of fun watching them though. It's really awesome to get in that close to them, to get so close that we could actually count the rings. But since that could be tricky, we didn't want to rely on that solely. So, had a great experience though.
We're gonna keep on hunting. It's really, really hard to leave two gorgeous rams like that alone. But
so we're just standing here having a granola bar. And these two ewes and lambs came down there about 60 yards away from us.
So we went in, stayed in camp last night, base camp. Today we left camp and we walked up about 2 to 3 miles up a different drainage. And so we've spotted some rams here. We just set up camp here for the night. And we're trying to determine whether or not these rams we're watching are legal or not. They look very close. So we're gonna watch them for a little while longer.
Watched 4 sheep, the biggest of which were these two. Again, we determined that these were not quite legal rams. The following morning, we hiked the upper reaches of this drainage looking for more sheep, but all we found were a couple of antler sheds.
All right, I guess it's Thursday, September 3rd here. You might have missed a day or two of the video journal. Got up this morning and it was still freezing. It's now about 75 degrees out here. We're headed out of this valley that we've been in here, and we're going to take a class a little bit on the way out, and then we're going to cross the river if we don't find anything on this side. See if we have some better luck over there. We've seen several ewes and lambs. There hasn't been a day go by yet that we didn't see a ram, but most of the rams we felt were too small to.
We crossed the river, and we spent the night at this lake, halfway up the mountain on the other side. The following morning, we were able to catch up to the sheep. We were able to determine that the middle ram was legal, so we maneuvered into position to get a shot.
We're watching 3 rams. We're 450 yards out. They're bedded down right now, waiting for them to stand before we take a shot.
I didn't compensate enough for the crosswind and hit this sheep a little bit far back. Fortunately, though, it was good enough to do the trick.
Okay, so it's September 5th?
September 5th, about 12:30 I would guess right now.
We made a stalk on some rams this morning. Got to about 450 yards and we were successful.
So this is our Alaska Dall Sheep ram. Jens and I have put a lot of work into this hunt. A lot of planning. Probably started a year ago, trying to make this happen. And although we have a lot of really incredible video and photos and experiences, this is kind of a memorial to show for it. And just a really beautiful creature here. We're really honored to have the opportunity to have hunted these guys and taken one.
Look at that. So here we're going to count the rings. So there's actually, you know, 8-year-old ram. We spent a couple days literally living with these animals, and I think they've earned our utmost respect. And Jens can probably attest it was a little bit of an emotional experience coming up and finding this guy, but...
Yep, it was.
Incredible animal. And I'm going to pan around. We can actually see camp from here. That is base camp. Can't see our spike camp. Our base camp's over on the end of this lake. It's about 3 miles away. At least. So yesterday, we spotted them from our base camp, and we came and we crossed the river, which was quite an ordeal. And we got up partway up this mountain and made camp, spike camp. And then this morning we got up really early and worked our way up this ridge and spotted these rams.
Jens, what are we getting ready to do?
Getting ready to eat some mutton.
Eat some mutton. We got potatoes boiling. And over here, we have mutton on skewers, little sheep tenderloin. And we also happen to have a Mountain House mac and cheese. And then hanging here nearby, we have a beautiful ram that we took today, and the cape. I'm going to tell you now, we are hungry fellas. Around 11:45, we got the ram. It was clear across the river up on the other side on top of the mountain. We got him quartered up. All the meat taken off, the cape and the antler, or the horns. And we headed down to our spike camp, gathered our spike camp, and then hoofed it all the way back here. We got back to camp right at dark. It was a really long, tough day, but a great one, to say the least. So I'm gonna shut off this camera so that I can cook some mutton.
That night, Alaska blessed us again with an incredible show. We spent most of the next day caring for our meat and preparing the cape and recuperating from the day before. But the following day, we got back to sheep hunting.
All right, so we got up early this morning. We spotted a band of rams, and we're currently stalking the rams. We just dropped our packs, and we're gonna have to work our way across this open meadow and up onto this rock slide up here. That's where the sheep are. I'll show you in a second.
We closed to 425 yards on these rams, then set up to make our shot.
Yes. Ram down.
Jens.
Yeah.
What do you have there?
A ram. He's about 8 years old.
Look at that.
It's got a broom tip here on the right.
It's a good looking ram. Okay. So give us a quick rundown of what happened this morning.
Well, you spotted these rams over here on the hill from our base camp. Spotted them, threw on some clothes, had to make our way around the lake, and got in position down there at the bottom of the mountain, about 425 yards away from him. Got set up and was able to take him from there.
All right. Sitting here by the campfire, we got back to camp with Jens's ram, so we have all the meat strung up. We just ate some fresh mutton tenderloin for dinner, and I think we're both pretty exhausted, but we accomplished what we set out to do. We got two rams. We used basically the whole time allotted to do it and had an incredible hunt, so we're very happy but very tired. So I think we're gonna hit the sack here. We hear our airplane a-coming, so we're gonna let him land and we'll get loaded up and get out of here. Last view of our home. We're gonna miss it.
Hello there, you happy hunters.
Hey there, Les.
How are you?
We're great.
Excellent.
We got rams.
That's so awesome.
All right, Jens and Les are getting loaded up.
As I sat there waiting for the plane to return, I relished in what little bit of time I had left. I reflected on what an incredible experience we had had and how fortunate we were to have that opportunity. As quick as we had come, now we were gone, taking with us an incredible memory and the hope of returning again someday.